I'll be showing breakout rooms in Microsoft Teams meetings. So I have a meeting here and I'm going to click it and I'll click join. So I'm going to join a meeting and we're going to break people into rooms and show exactly how this all works. So let's click join. Hey folks, so to get started, what I'm going to do is on the top of my meeting, there's this little breakout rooms icon and I'm going to click this. The first thing it's going to ask me is how many breakout rooms do you want to create? Now I'll just be creating 4 today and I'll drop this down and choose 4, but you can create up to 50 breakout rooms. So you've got a lot of flexibility. The other option here is participants. And would you like to automatically assign them, which I'll be doing here. And it says assign 15 people into 4 rooms, or you can choose to manually add participants into each breakout room. But I'll be choosing automatically and I'll say create room. Now in the right-hand pane, you can see it's created 4 different rooms and it has 4 people, 4 people, 4 people, and 3. The number of people is indicated with that little parentheses there. Now I could choose to add additional rooms here, which I'm not gonna do, but I can also rename the rooms. So in this case, I'm gonna choose the dot, dot, dot menu and choose to rename this room and we'll give them colors. So this is the blue room. And we'll just speed ahead and rename the other room's colors. What I can do next is I can actually choose to move people around. So you can see as I open up each room, you can see these people are assigned automatically to the rooms. And I haven't started the rooms yet. So let's say I have Mr. Adam Short Shorts here. He's in the blue room. But you know what? I think he's on Team Flipgrid. He should be in the green room, right, Adam? So let's assign, and I'm gonna move Adam over to the green room. So now down here, you can see that Adam is in the green room. So it's really easy to move people around if they're not in the room that gets automatically assigned. Let's go into room settings. So go to the dot, dot, dot and click room settings. And by default, everyone gets automatically moved into open rooms, but I can uncheck that if I wanted to do it manually, but we'll leave it checked. Also, you can recreate the rooms. What does that mean? That means I can blast away all the current rooms and it will let me recreate like 5 or 10 more rooms. I'm not gonna do that right here, but if you need to restart and blast them away, that's where you do it. And now we are ready to start our rooms. So I'm gonna click the Start Rooms button right here. And on the attendee side, what's gonna happen is they're gonna get pulled into the breakout room that I've set up. So they'll get pulled out of this main meeting and they will get pulled into their breakout room meetings. And then we'll show what it looks like to be inside on the attendee side. So let's click Start Rooms and get ready to say goodbye to everyone. They're gonna get moved into their rooms. Bye. Now, what if somebody joins the meeting late? Like, here's an example right here.
Oh my gosh, Mike, I'm totally late. Where do I go?
Oh, don't worry, Anne. I will be able to assign you to a room. You know, I think you would be perfect in the green room with Team Flipgrid. So I'm going to assign Anne right here. So Anne Cosma, I'm going to select her name and choose assign. And it asks which room. I'm going to put you in the green room. Bye-bye, Anne. One thing I can do is send a message to everyone that I want to communicate. So I can make an announcement across all the breakout rooms. Hey folks, start brainstorming on your whiteboard and I'll send this and everyone will get this message in their chat. Now note in the upper right, there's a new announcement, a new message. Now Steven's gonna open the chat panel and this is a message sent by the organizer, who is me in this case. So that comes right through and everyone can get a sense of what the announcements are. Now I'm gonna leave this meeting and go show how the organizer can officially join into another breakout room. I'm gonna go visit the green room and see how they're doing in there. I click the dot, 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 and I'll click join room. That is a beautiful looking whiteboard. I'm joining the green room. This is where the party is. Woo! Great, so I'm gonna go and leave now and make a message post to tell everyone to come back into the main room. I'll see y'all later. And then to just go back into my main meeting, I click resume. Now the breakout rooms have had plenty of time to be working on their brainstorming. I'm gonna send a message that I'll be closing the breakout rooms in just a minute. So we go to the dot, dot, dot again, choose make an announcement. I'll be closing the breakout rooms in 1 minute. So I'll send this out. We've sent an announcement to all the rooms. Okay, now to close the rooms out and bring everyone back into this meeting, I'm gonna click close rooms. So it'll bring everyone back. Now I've switched to one of the breakout rooms to show what they experienced. There's a message that appears that says this room will close in 10 seconds and you'll automatically be moved back into the main meeting.
Hey everyone, welcome back from the breakout rooms.
Looks like lots of great brainstorming and collaboration was happening in there.